Hey guys, it is Dani and welcome to this video, and I am just here doing a season review of what the hurricane season for 2020 was. We are now at the official end of the season. The season ended yesterday, the 30th of November, and so this season was the most active in recorded history, guys. And so guys, before I go into further details, please do subscribe if you haven't and tap the notification bell so you know every time when I post a new video, because I will keep you guys updated on tropical activity at all times. And you can also follow me on Instagram. My weather account is at the girl Dani'i and my personal account is Dani'i Henry Official. Okay guys, so looking at the seasonal statistics, so for this season we've had 31 tropical depressions tied with 2005, 30 named storms, 13 hurricanes, and 6 major hurricanes. So we are just one major hurricane short of being tied with what was that of 2005, because 2005 produced 7 major hurricanes and also 15 hurricanes, and this season produced 13. So 2 hurricanes short and 1 major hurricane short. And so the total fatalities for this season over 400, unfortunately, and the damage is probably more than $41 billion in 2020 US dollars. So a lot has definitely happened. This has been a very destructive hurricane season, and the strongest storm of the season was of course Hurricane Iota, which was a Cat 5. It had peak winds of 160 miles per hour and it made landfall in Nicaragua, just a few miles south of where Ada made landfall just 2 weeks prior to that, guys. So this was a very disastrous November hurricane, and one that has definitely gone down in the history books. And things were very favorable this season, and you might be wondering, why was this season so active? And the reason for that is because of the La Nina that has been ongoing, that really fueled these tropical cyclones. It really resulted in more favorable conditions for them to intensify. So what is exactly a La Nina, you may be wondering? So it's basically we have the El Nino Southern Oscillation in the Pacific, and so when we're having that cooling phase of it, it results in cooler ocean temperatures in the eastern Pacific, but the opposite in the Atlantic, and that is called a La Nina. So when we have the La Nina, it simply means that there is more favorable conditions. So we're talking about the less wind shear during the season and warmer than usual ocean temperatures, and those are two major factors that play a significant role in a tropical cyclone's life. And so guys, that is the reason this season has been so active. And usually these cycles just go on for several months or so, I believe about 6 months or so. So hopefully next season we see some sorts of cool down, but again, these things can sneak up on us. They can even go on for years. So let's just hope for the best for next hurricane season, guys. And so guys, for the 2021 Atlantic hurricane season, the names are Anna, Bill, Claudette, Dani, Elsa, Fred, Grace, Henry, Ida, Julian, Kate, Larry, Mindy, Nicholas, Odette, Peter, Rose, Sam, Teresa, Victor, and Wanda. So is your name on the list for the 2021 Atlantic hurricane season? And again, that season will begin on the 1st of June, but it is possible that the season can begin before that time, because we have had I believe about 5 or 6 consecutive years now of where we have pre-season storms which give the seasons a head start. I believe dating back to about, I think it was 2015 or 2016, not quite sure on that one, but I know that we've been having a lot of consecutive years where we have pre-season storms that give the seasons a head start. So is that going to happen for 2021? It simply cannot be predicted, at least as of right now, because we're still in 2020, and of course a lot of things are going to be changing as we progress into the new year. So guys, it is a big sigh of relief for a lot of persons that we have arrived at the end of this very hyperactive season. But again, we can have off-season storms, but at this time we're not seeing the very likelihood of that happening, guys. And so guys, that is really it for this video, and if you found it to be pretty informative, please give a thumbs up, and you can also share your thoughts in the comments or ask questions. I'll try to respond as best innocent as I can, and just remember to always be with the wise.